ओम नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर डूइंग द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी बिपिन चौधरी'स लैप्स ऑफ मेमोरी। वी सॉ दैट बिपिन बाबू हैज फिनिश्ड बाइंग द बुक्स एंड नाउ ही इज कमिंग बैक टू हिज होम एंड ही इज कॉन्स्टेंटली प्रीऑक्युपाइड विद द थॉट्स ऑफ द स्ट्रेंजर ही हैड एनकाउंटर्ड। सो नाउ लेट्स कम टू द टेक्स्ट। देन बिपिन बाबू सडनली थॉट ऑफ दिनेश मुखर्जी। द मैन हैड सेड दैट दिनेश वॉज इन रांची एट द सेम टाइम। द बेस्ट थिंग श्योरली वुड बी टू आस्क हिम। He lived quite near, in Beninandan Street. What about going right now? But then, if he had really never been to Ranchi, what would Dinesh think if Bipin Babu asked for a confirmation? He would probably conclude Bipin Babu was going nuts. No, it would be ridiculous to ask him. And he knew how ruthless Dinesh's sarcasm could be. Sipping a cold drink in his air-conditioned living room, Bipin Babu felt at ease again. Such a nuisance. Just because they have nothing else to do, they go about getting into other people's hair. After dinner, snuggling in bed with one of the new thrillers, Bipin Babu forgot all about the man in Newmarket. So then the idea of contacting Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee came to his mind. The stranger, Porimol Ghosh, had said that he was with him in Ranchi in 1958. So the best thing Bipin Babu could do then was to contact Dinesh. And he even lived quite nearby in Beninandan Street. He was in a dilemma whether to contact Dinesh Babu for confirmation. Because if Bipin Babu had really never gone to Ranchi, then Dinesh might believe that Bipin Babu has gone mad. So he concluded that it would be stupid to ask him. Also, he remembered that Dinesh Mukherjee was extremely unforgiving and scornful in his verbal remarks. The cool drink and the cool air of the air conditioner of his living room made him feel at ease again. He again thought to himself that he has been wasting time and there are some worthless people whose only work is to intrude into others' life and annoy them. After finishing his dinner, he curled up in his bed with one of the thrillers that he had brought from Kalicharan's bookshop and he completely forgot about that Porimol Ghosh. Next day in the office, Bipin Babu noticed that with every passing hour, the previous day's encounter was occupying more and more of his mind. If the man knew so much about Bipin Babu, how could he make such a mistake about the Ranchi trip? Just before lunch, Bipin Babu decided to ring up Dinesh Mukherjee. It was better to settle the question over the phone. At least the embarrassment on his face wouldn't show. The next day, that is on Tuesday, Bipin Babu realized that every passing hour is making the incident all the more compelling and acute in his mind. He was thinking that if a man can tell so many correct facts about Bipin Babu, it is unlikely that the same person will make a mistake about the Ranchi trip. So Bipin Babu made up his mind that he will call up Dinesh Mukherjee, and he did so right before lunch. He thought that it was better to speak about the matter over the phone rather than in person in order to avoid embarrassment. 235616. Bipin Babu dialed the number. Hello, is that Dinesh? This is Bipin here. Well, what's the news? I just wanted to find out if you recalled an incident which took place in 1958. 1958? What incident? Were you in Calcutta right through that year? That's the first thing I've got to know. Wait just a minute. 1958. Just let me check in my diary. For a minute, there was silence. Bipin Babu could feel that his heartbeat had gone up. He was sweating a little. Hello. Yes, I've got it. I'd been out twice. Where? Once in February, nearby, to Krishnanagar to a nephew's wedding. And then, but you would know about this one, the trip to Ranchi. You were there too, that's all. But what's all this sleuthing about? No, I just wanted to. Anyway, thanks. Bipin Babu slammed the receiver down and gripped his head with his hands. He felt his head swimming. A chill seemed to spread over his body. There were sandwiches in his tiffin box, but he did not eat them. He had lost appetite. So Bipin Babu called up Dinesh Mukherjee and straight asked about what was troubling him. He wanted to know whether Dinesh was in Calcutta all through the year. Dinesh replied that he will have to check it in his diary. For a minute there was a silence and Bipin Babu was having palpitation and he was also sweating a bit. Dinesh Babu returned to the call and said that he had been out of station twice in 1958. He went to Krishnanagar in February to attend his nephew's wedding and the other one was with Bipin Babu to Ranchi. Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee further inquired why was Bipin Babu investigating all this. Bipin Babu could not even give a proper reply and he disconnected the call. As Bipin Babu kept down the receiver of the landline phone, he felt that his head was swirling and he held his head with his hands. Though he had brought sandwiches for lunch, he did not feel like eating them. So here we see that what Bipin Babu was afraid of the most had really come true. Now it is again time to solve these questions. I am reminding you students that all these questions must be properly written down with their answers in your English literature copy. The first question is, why did Bipin Babu worry about what Porimal Ghosh had said? Bipin Babu continuously worried about what Porimal Ghosh had said because he had shown that he knew many intimate facts about him. He knew about the bag of books, his wife's death and his brother's insanity. Considering that Porimal Ghosh knew so much about him, Bipin Babu could not say with conviction that he was making a mistake about the Ranchi trip. However, Bipin Babu knew that he had an excellent memory and if he truly had forgotten such an incident, then the only other possibility was that he was losing his mind. Question number 2. How did he try to decide who was right, his memory or Porimal Ghosh? He tried to decide whether his memory was right or Porimal Ghosh by first writing to his friend Haridas, who lived in Kanpur and whom he had spent the puja holidays with in 1958. But then he suddenly remembered that his friend had left for Japan and he did not have his present address. He then decided to look at his right knee where Porimal had claimed that there would be a cut. There was certainly a mark of an old cut. However, he could not decide if the cut was the result of his fall in Ranchi or due to some other incident in his childhood. He finally decided to ask Dinesh Mukherjee, who, according to Porimal Ghosh, was with him in Ranchi. He felt that asking him would put an end to his confusion. Why did Bipin Babu hesitate to visit Mr. Mukherjee? Why did he finally decide to phone him? Bipin Babu hesitated to visit Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee because he was afraid of the ruthless sarcasm he would have to face. He felt that if the whole story about Ranchi was false, then Mr. Mukherjee would think that he had gone insane. This therefore would be a ridiculous idea. Being constantly troubled by the incident at the bookshop and having no other means of verifying the claims of Porimal Ghosh, Bipin Babu finally decided to ask Mr. Mukherjee. However, he decided to call him because that way his embarrassment wouldn't be visible to the latter or Dinesh Mukherjee. The last question. What did Mr. Mukherjee say? Did it comfort Bipin Babu or add to his worries? Mr. Mukherjee said that they had indeed gone to Ranchi in 1958. This added to Bipin Babu's worries as he could not figure out how he could possibly have forgotten about the trip. The moment he got the news, he slammed the receiver down and gripped his head with his hands. His head started to swim and a chill seemed to spread over his body. He was so worried that he even lost his appetite. So we have completed the second part of the story as well. In the next online class, we will move ahead with the part 3. Thank you, students. Om Namah Shivaya.